In this chapter of video manual for message crawler, we're talking about Google Hangouts. Let's jump to PowerPoint and start with the theory, and then we'll move on to practical examples of how to work with Google Hangouts. All right, to import data into message crawler, you will click on the big button that says Google Hangouts, where you will be greeted with a screen where you can import Google Hangouts data. Now, you need to export your data from Google Hangouts using Google Takeout. And what you'll get is a JSON file with number of attachments. And Hangouts.json is the file you want to load into Google Hangouts. Whenever you download data with Google Takeout, not all the attachments get exported. I'm sure it's a bug of some sort, but there is a second problem there too, where if you have attachments that have duplicative names, they will be saved with (1), (2), and so on, which looks okay at the export. However, inside your JSON files, the paths do not correctly reflect renamed files. So renaming happens separately, but the JSON file never gets updated. So the attachments you get from Google Takeout are no good. What we're going to do is re-download all the attachments because a JSON file contains path to where they stored in the cloud. Because of that, you're going to click on download attachments button and they will be saved to your local drive. It is very important to always download attachments every time you open a JSON file. Even if you download attachments before, still click on download attachments button. It is important to recreate that internal link between metadata and attachments. And if the attachments have been downloaded before, message crawler is smart enough to find the file already there and not to re-download it again. So always click on download attachments button after you open the JSON file. All right, so from here we can export our data either to that file or to grid. If you want to put it into that file, like you want to load it to concordance, you can do that. You always want to generate unique identifier because that's what we do in lit support. And if you want to continue with RSMF conversion, you put data into the grid so that we could map that data. Okay, we have one more bug to talk about, and sometimes user names cannot be found during export. In that case, user ID will be used instead. If you find these, this is normal. Unfortunately, this is normal. There's nothing I can do about it. This is how data comes out using Google Takeout. So if they fix it, then you will be fine. If they don't, then you have a user ID in there. I do have some tools on how to fix it, which we'll talk about later. It's a tool called name normalization. So we can use that tool to actually fix these names. But if you see these unknown IDs, that's just how Google exports data. All right, and when you load data into Grid, you will get automatically generated conversation. A conversation will be created based on conversation ID and day. So each day per conversation will get a new RSMF file or a new conversation in this case. And if you choose to use this field as a conversation identifier, you will get one RSMF file per day per conversation. And you also get sort date created for you as well. All right, your field mapping should look similar to this. In your conversation identifier, it's up to you whether to use the conversation that was generated or use the conversation ID that gets created by Google. All right, and with that, let's jump into demo and actually see how we can take Google Hangouts data and convert it into RSMF. So here I have Google messages that I've downloaded using Google Takeout. This is my JSON file and these are my attachments. So I talked about these in the PowerPoint. So these files do not get associated correctly. So I do not recommend using these attachments. Just for speed of this demo, I downloaded attachments ahead of time, and you can see that I have downloaded 115 attachments using Message Crawler as opposed to only 27 using Google Takeout. So let's go into Message Crawler, load this JSON file, and make some RSMF files out of it. So I'm going to click on Google Hangouts, and I'm going to say import Google Hangouts. We are going to navigate to folder where we have Google Hangouts, open the JSON file, and now it'll tell us we've loaded 30 conversations. From here, I'm going to click on download attachments. Message crawler just checked to make sure all the files were there. two were missing. It tried to download them. It could not, so it told us about it. So there are two files that could not be downloaded. If you were to go to the JSON file, find the link, and try to paste that into a browser, you will get same error files. Those two files, for whatever reason, are gone and cannot be downloaded. Right, so now we can assign our unique number as we always like to do, and we're going to load data to grid. All right, as far as field mappings, we have our control number and group identifier mapped automatically. We have our conversation ID. So this is a conversation that's generated by Google. We can use that to generate our SMF files, or we can use our conversation that was generated by this conversation ID and also split up by day. So each day within this conversation ID is going to be a new RSMF file. We have our participants and from, so we're going to map them appropriately. So sender from here and our participants here, which actually did not get mapped automatically. So you should check that as well. So we have our participants. We have message type. Body is our content here, which is perfect. And everything looks like it's good. We have our attachments on the right. So if we look, if we scroll down, we'll find some attachments. I'm not going to spend time on this. And the last thing we need to check is that we have our names delimiter, which is a semicolon, which is perfect. I'm going to leave this conversation as is. So I'm going to pick my export location. I'm going to say generate export. And now my RSMF file should show up right here. And you can see they're still going. And now that the conversion is done, we can take these RSMF files, we can use relativity processing to load them into relativity and, well, enjoy our newly created RSMF files. Relativity processing is a separate step, and I covered that in a separate chapter. All right, and that's it. That's how you would convert Google Hangouts data to RSMF files. I have a separate chapter on processing and loading to relativity, so check that out as well. And I will see you on the next chapter of Message Caller Video Manual.